Mr. Chinnappan, could you tell us about Kalvi Kendra?
Yes, Kalvi Kendra is the organization which born on the bed of disaster, but it's a human, man-made disaster. There was a communal clash in Vilupuram town in 1979.
Vilupuram?
Yes, in Vilupuram town, in which 12 Dalits were killed and 250 houses were burnt. So to do the rehabilitation work, we have started this organization. We constructed the houses to the victims, and also we did a lot of development program to children and women in that, area.
Sustaining it must be quite a tough job now over the years.
Definitely. Definitely, it's a sustaining.
So what are your achievements? What would you rate?
Actually, we organize the people into people's organizations, self-help groups, women groups, occupational groups.
Yeah.
And after the motivation, we linked this group with the financial institution, banks, for access to continuous financial support. And also we linked them with the insurance company for the risk cover. Also we linked them with some of the training institution for their skill development. And also we created a lot of apex bodies among the people.
Yeah.
It's an inbuilt mechanism to take care of those activities.
So the secret is to link them with existing facilities?
Yes, linkages is very, very important. And also we link them with the government programs through, so that they can avail their rights and the facilities.
Mostly Dalit population?
We started with Dalit population.
Yeah.
Then we shifted to the people who are living in below poverty line. Yes.
And in as far as the people go, they don't get tired or fed up of the activities, or they see a benefit in it?
See, actually, sometimes we got frustration. But anyhow, whenever we go to the village, whenever we meet the people, whenever we interacted with them, we again got enthusiasm. And right now, I am completing my 33 years in the social development.
In the same organization?
In the same organization.
You set it up?
Yes. It's a Claude, Father Claude.
You were mentioning Father Claude.
Father Claude was the then director of IKF, All India Catholic University Federation. He is the person, I think everybody knows that IKF is the, Father Claude period is the golden period. Because he is not only concentrated only with the students, and also he mainly, his vision was very broad. He always thinking about the society. We can call him as a social scientist. He wanted to do some innovations to bring the social change. So he introduced a pilot programs when he was in IKF in the rural areas. So Vilupuram was one among them. And he did lot of development works, lot of rehabilitation and relief work. And also, above all, he concentrated the giving motivation to the students regarding the situation of India. And his main aim is to eradicate poverty and illiteracy.
And in some ways, they have succeeded, you would say?
Yes, definitely. Who are all trained in IKF, who are all motivated in IKF, they're all successfully doing so many interventions, so many development activities and people's organization activities, social action activities throughout Tamil Nadu, even throughout India, I can say.
Tamil Nadu and Bangalore, Karnataka, they are, center of NGOs in India. Which would you rate as the most active or the...
This is because of IKF. I can say this because of IKF, but regarding Karnataka, I cannot say. Maybe because of ISI, Indian Social Institute.
I see. But which are the ones you look up to in these areas? In NGOs, which are the good NGOs doing good work?
In Tamil Nadu?
Yeah.
You want me the list?
No, I mean the top two or three, which are the best?
See, actually, when Ozzy Fernandez was there, he's the national advisor at those time. He is doing his HRF, Human Rights Foundation.
He
is tremendously organizing the... empowering the elected leaders, especially the Dalit and the women. He's trained in IKF. He has been closely working with the government of Tamil Nadu. He wants to change the policies. He wants to give full power to the elected leaders. He's doing tremendous work. I know him. He's an IKFer. And also, if you come the south side, there is another organization called Palmera. And he created Palmera and ACD animators for community development in Viluppuram district. And so many organizations. Right now, I cannot.
But what are the shortcomings of NGOs in Tamil Nadu? What are the problems? Is it difficult to sustain, or the change will not be scalable? What do you see as the problems?
See, actually, you mean the challenges of NGOs. No?
Yeah.
Regarding the policies, so many NGOs, different NGOs adopt different policies.
Yeah.
But to get the resources, but it's very difficult to mobilize resources from government of India for the NGO sustainability. But for the programs, it is we can mobilize as much money as possible from the government of India, from the government, the state government.
Fitting into their programs.
Yes. Regarding the administration, and I think government of India is not encouraging the volunteerism.
There is a certain bit of cynicism or suspicion towards
NGOs.
Yes,
suspicious over NGOs.
Since Indira Gandhi's famous remark of the foreign hand.
Yes.
So it's not encouraging.
It's not encouraging.
But you all feel that the impact is there.
A lot of impact, because the world is divided into three sectors, you know, the public sector, private sector, and voluntary sector.
Right.
Voluntary sector is always for the human concern. You know. They should work with the government. Government should implement some of the humanitarian programs, some of the welfare programs, some of the development programs in consultation with the NGOs, and sometimes they should implement the program through NGOs. So government should give some sort of importance even during their policy making for these development activities and welfare programs. It's, but right now we don't find all these things from the government.
Thank you so much.
Yes.